happening, my people? Jord95 Wrestling back with another video, and we are at For the Love of Wrestling 2024. Now, I did this last year. It's in Manchester, for all of you that don't know, and it's a wrestling convention, the biggest in Europe. And yeah, it's just a convention where you get autographs, you meet different superstars from over the years. There's all sorts of stands, vendors. Everyone watching this will know what For the Love of Wrestling is, but yeah, I'm recording this intro on the Sunday morning currently, so I have done the full weekend. Well, I am doing the full weekend. So I'm in my hotel room about to go and do the Sunday, but I just wanted to quickly do this intro. You will be seeing in this video clips from Saturday and from today, from the Sunday. I'll just be showing you the vendors, the people who I meet and everything. I'll be showing you a haul as well of what I pick up throughout the weekend. But yeah, this is the last day of For the Love of Wrestling. But this is the For the Love of Wrestling 2024 vlog. I hope you all enjoy. Let me know if you were there as well. If you're watching this, let me know who you met and what you picked up, etc. But yeah, let's get into it. Right, guys, so we're inside. Little bit of a different setup this year. We've got the WrestleMania prop stand, Future Shock ring, the Raw entrance as well, with the Progress ring. This year, everything's a bit different. The vendors are mainly the other side, so it's split in half, and that's a lot better because last year it got really crammed. But yeah, I'm going to let you have a look at some of these awesome paintings and the awesome British wrestling stall that we have on this side. It is worth noting as well that Big Daddy and Kendo Nagasaki as well are the guys that I was first introduced to when my family showed me wrestling. This guy on this store had a lot of looses. I was really interested in a lot of them. I really wanted to go and have a good rummage through. But first, we got to meet the boys.
Say hello, lads.
Oi, oi.
Yeah, shout out to James and AJ and Finn. Absolute legends. On this stall, there is a point here where I pick up this D'Lo Brown. Keep an eye on that when I show you my haul later on. I want to shout out this guy as well. The way he had his jacks specifically packaged, it was very, very good. Like, I'm a very big jacks guy, and being able to see all of them like this, it was absolutely awesome for myself. I didn't actually pick anything up, which I kind of regret looking back at this footage, because the amount he had was quality. He did have old school this side and then Mattel the other side. And also this Punjabi prison, which I've actually never seen in person, so this was the first. Can't believe how big it is. Shout out the guys at Real Wrestling as well with their wheel that they always have. And yeah, it's very good fun.
very serious. And so I would, but you know, all that time over here, all the tours and that, I would go out, Finley was always a sightseer. So I would always go out with him, at least, we would always go, you know what, we're going to pick one day and go actually do things. And it was always kind of a goal in my head.
Also, big shout out to the China cosplay, absolutely awesome, had to get a picture. And also I met the legend himself, Gangrel, got my Major Bendy signed. What a moment, and yeah, what a guy, he was absolutely so down to earth and a good guy. I love some of the belts on this store, but a bit out of my price range. You got Ric Flair robe as well. Some belts, Sergeant Slaughter belt, some really, really cool stuff on here. So as we're recording, we turn around and Elijah, otherwise known as Elias, is coming to the ring. So yeah, let's stop and watch this. And now the moment we've all been waiting for, Trish and Lita Q&A. I'm not going to put the entrance in. I don't want to get done for copyright, of course, with their music. But yeah, I just wanted to show you just the reaction, the crowd. There was such a big crowd. I think this was like the biggest crowd for a Q&A. It was the main event for me. It was right at prime time in the day as well. It was a good time where everyone was there. So yeah, it was an absolutely awesome moment of the weekend. This is where the guests were as well. This is the way it was set up. Last year it was more like big banners in behind them. This year it was like little electronic stands. I think it looked better, but I kind of miss having the banners because you can buy the banners from behind them. And that's what I did last year. So I was hoping to grab one again this year, but they were all online this year. I met one of the nicest people I've ever met, Maria Kanellis. You're a diamond. Thank you so much for your time. We also met Rhino as well, the ECW legend. This was a big moment for me. I'm an ECW fanboy, so to meet the man beast for the first time didn't disappoint. We also had to throw the ones up with Big Keish as well. Yeah, what a guy. What a legend. And then the last Q&A that I watched of the day was Rhino. And I had to stay for this one. Like I said before, ECW legend. Those of you that know me know how much ECW meant to me personally. So to actually sit front row for this, yeah, it was a big moment for myself. Also, a massive shout out to these four guys as well. Sean Swaggle, Jimmy Wrestling, otherwise known as James, Finn Galore Wrestling Figures, and AJWF. Legends, absolute legends. Had a great day. Finally, we all met up together. Yeah, my absolute boys. Right, so I had a lot of people asking me what I picked up from the event. I didn't pick up a lot, to be fair, compared to what I normally do, but this is what I picked up. So, originally, I saw this. I'm not going to keep it in the box because it is sun damaged, but I need this figure, the pirate Paul Burchill with the sword. So I asked them originally at the beginning of the day how much you want for it. They said 30 quid. I wasn't going to pay 30 quid because I just needed the Paul Burchill. I've got this Regal. I just needed the Pirate Burchill. So I waited until later on. And then I went back and they were selling it for a tenner. They said you can have it for a tenner because we just want to take as less stock home as possible. So I picked this up for a tenner. And I also picked up this D'Lo Brown off the same guy for a tenner. As well as the Randy shirt as well. So I got that for a fiver, the shirt. I got D'Lo for a tenner. And I got this for a tenner as well, which is absolutely awesome. So 25 quid for the lot. I was buzzing with it. So yeah, I picked that up to get Pirate Paul Burchill. Also got the D'Lo as well. This is a figure I've always wanted. And I missed out on it when it first came out. So had to pick up that one. Yeah. Awesome figure. Then off one of the guys' stalls, I picked up this Ruthless Aggression Series 6 Kurt Angle, the Team Angle attire. Anyone who knows me knows how much I love Ruthless Aggression. So yeah, that was a must for me. This was my Major Bendy that I got signed by Gangrel. It came out really clean. I was buzzing with that. And I love the Major Bendy line. I'm going to have to get some more. I like the Extreme ones, the ECW ones. So I'm going to pick up them too. We picked up this loose. I believe it's Classic Superstars. Shawn Michaels. That was only 6 quid, as you can see. And it's in really good condition. So I thought, why not? I also picked up this. This was on like... They were doing like a free 8x10s. Like, you just pick them up off the table and take them. And I thought this one was quite cool. I was having a look through and do you know what? I was like, yeah, I'll get them to sign that one day. So yeah, Dudley Boys 8x10. And then the shirts we picked up. I picked up a Viper Randy Orton shirt off that guy, as I said, the one who let me have a discount on everything at the end of the day. So an Apex Predator t-shirt. And then I also picked up a Gangrel t-shirt off Gangrel himself. He was selling some UK exclusive merch. So yeah, I thought, why not? So that was my haul. It's not the biggest haul, but yeah, that's what I picked up at For the Love of Wrestling. Thank you for watching, guys. If you enjoyed, please leave a like and a comment. Let me know if you went to For the Love of Wrestling at the weekend. I'm sure you all had the best time if you did, because it was absolutely awesome weekend catching up with friends. And yeah, meeting my heroes. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.